Namaste doston, this is Andrew Praveen. Today in this video I'm going to talk about a few features that Jeep, the original Jeep company, the FCA, Fiat Chrysler Automobiles, did not introduce in the Indian market. So this is the 2017 Jeep Compass, the Indian Jeep Compass, which come with a set of features. And when I start investigating the features available in the US Jeep Compass, there's a lot many features that were extra, additional, that we're going to discuss in this video today. Now, before I start off with the features one by one, I want you all to think why FCA has not introduced these features in the Indian market, and leave it down your thoughts in the comment section below, and let's start discussing on those things. And I'm really hoping that they will introduce these features in the upcoming upgrades of the Jeep Compass, especially the 2018 version. So let's begin one by one. The first feature that I will start off with is the engine. The engine in the US market is 2.4 liter multi-air petrol engine, which is 6-speed automatic. Now, what do we have in India? We have, as we are probably aware, 1.4 liter engine for petrol, multi-air engine, and a diesel engine, which we will not find in the US market. Since there is a good market for diesel vehicles in India, they have this 2-liter engine, 2-liter multi-jet engine in India. So that's a big difference, and 2.4 liter petrol engine that comes with a lot of power, unmatched power when you compare that with 1.4 liter multi-air engine that we have in India. Coming on to the next feature that we do not have. The Apple Maps support in the Uconnect car infotainment system. Can you imagine a car with an infotainment system? Of course, we have an infotainment system. Can you imagine a car with an infotainment system without the support for Maps? Especially people who are using iPhone, Apple freaks, they won't be able to use their Apple Maps along with their Jeep Compass in India. Whereas in US Jeep Compass, they do have support for Apple Maps, and that works so closely with Apple products, and there is no issues. But unfortunately, we don't have it in. I have absolutely no clue as to why they have not introduced that crucial feature when it comes to car navigation in the Indian Jeep Compass. And the third feature that we do not have is the blind spot and the cross path detection feature.
The available blind spot monitoring system helps you make safer lane changes by alerting you when a vehicle enters your blind spot zone. Sensors scan approximately one lane over on each side. When a sensor detects a vehicle in the blind spot zone, an icon lights up on the corresponding exterior mirror. Rear cross path detection helps you back out of parking spaces when vehicles block your view. When moving in reverse, sensors scan for vehicles and/or objects crossing your path, and the system alerts you with a lighted icon in the exterior mirror.
My wild guess is that since these kind of smart features are expensive to introduce, Jeep might bump up their price, the on-road price for the India Jeep Compass, and probably they might introduce that feature in the future. But let's wait and see. Okay guys, here comes the next feature. Rain sensing intermittent windshield wipers. We do not have a rain sensing wiper in the India Jeep Compass, whereas the US Jeep Compass has that feature. The most important feature of all is the cattle sensing. Oh shit, we do not have any such feature in the Jeep Compass. Alright guys, the last candidate in the list is the Uconnect screen size. We have only 7-inch screen in the India Jeep Compass, whereas the US Jeep Compass has 8.4 inches bigger screen. Just imagine, 1.4 inches makes a big difference when it comes to infotainment system, when you actually put it in a console out there. This, I feel a little smaller, cramped, and for an SUV of this size, they could have easily given 8.4 inches like they gave it in the US market. We do not have that. I have absolutely no clue. The design, everything is the same, the signature Jeep dash design, but this is smaller, only 7 inches instead of 8.4 inches. Which I feel is a definite drawback when it comes to what they could provide, because I do not think there is any reason for them to reduce this whole console size. Let's hope they take care of this in the future generations.
That's all guys, to sum it up, I take great pains to shoot this video. I just, you know, come out here in a very deserted place, far away from my home, and just to shoot this video for you all. And I want to help you guys to understand, you know, to what is missing and what we can expect. And this will definitely, I'm sure, will help your buying decision in the future, and to talk more authentically, authoritatively about Jeep Compass to your friends and things like that. And again,
If you really like this video, do support me, subscribe to this channel, please, and do like and share and give all your comments and criticism in this comment section down below, and that will definitely be helping me a lot. Thank you so much once again for your time. I'll see you all soon. Bye-bye. This is Anil Praveen signing off.